Happy evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Welcome to the Utama Toastmasters Club meeting for tonight. It's a pleasure to see all of you here, despite the rain and wet weather. You made effort and time to join us in this meeting, which I believe you will enjoy very much. We are all learning and sharing together. Give all yourself a round of applause for that. Now, what I want to share with you today is, of course, most of you would know that last weekend, the District 51 held the annual conference, Toastmasters conference, for 22nd year, and was held in a beautiful hotel called One Hotel in beautiful island of Langkawi. A few of us were there, myself, Chishiva Lingam, and one more member who's not here with us today is Kelvin. So it was a very successful conference. I enjoyed it very much. One of the highlights of that conference was this world champion for public speaking career, Dhananjaya Haitaraji from the island of Ceylon, Sri Lanka, shared with us his moments of success. It was a very inspiring speech. And what I wanted to do is share the highlights of his speech, very motivational, inspirational. Our GE Chow was there too, and I'm sure you find it just as motivating. Five things he says to us. You got to believe your dream is possible. You have to believe your dream is possible. That's the first thing he told us. The belief part. Secondly, it's an attitude. Are we comfortable with failure? Are we becoming failure now? How do you feel when we fail? We get up and move on? Yeah. That's why he says, you've got to be comfortable with failure. And expanded further, he says, there's a resilience built in failure. Is the resilience you need for success. So failure is just a stepping stone. Even though we go for contests, we feel to get a placing. That does not deter us from competing again and again. That's just what he said. And the third thing says, little things make big difference. That's it from the Met Club. Make a difference, even though small things or big things. They do make a difference. And learn to be a better person before you can become a better speaker. Which we have to be our factor. You want to be a better speaker, be a better person first. And last, sustain for success. How do we sustain for success? What do you need? Find a mentor, a good mentor who will always encourage you when you're down. Will never give up hope on you. That is the role of the mentor. Help you out, sustain you, motivate you, inspire you. If you are feeling dejected, feeling down, that's why we need that mentor. Give us back the uplift of the spirit and God fighting again. In a sense, use an acronym. BALLS. You've got to have balls to be successful. Balls, B, belief. A, attitude. L, little things, make a difference. Another L, learn to be a better person. And S, sustain for success. So, in short, you have to get balls. And his mentor say, you got to find a ball. If you don't have one, get one. If you don't can't get one, borrow one. And you can't borrow one, you can borrow his ball. Stay with you. And what he says, the speech that is very scientific, I'm not sure whether it's proven. They say, if the distance between your nose and your lips is the same as the distance between your eyes, then you are beautiful, handsome. If the distance differs by more than 2 mm, then you lose the chance of looking good by 16%. Last he says, it was more than 4 mm, you lose the chance of looking good by 50%. Is that proven? Have you measured that nose, the distance between your nose and your lips, and the distance between your eyes? Are they equidistant? If they are, then you should be beautiful or handsome. If they are not, because by more than 2 mm, lose a chance of looking good by 16%. It's more than 4 mm, lose a chance of looking good by 50%. Well, this is very scientific and hope you all can benefit from this. Now I'd like to pass control to the DME, but before I pass it on, our DME has been a club member for 2 years now, and he told me he enjoys movies and sports. But tell me that he enjoys also handling this because the AK-47. Wow. So he's our former BPM, he's a member, committee member this year. And without much further, let's give a warm welcome to our Toastmaster evening tonight, BK2.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. My name is BK, I'm the Toastmaster of the evening. Today I have chosen the theme, the Maze Runner. It's actually inspired by one of the movies that was shown last year. I don't know if you actually watched it before. It talks about a group of people living in a peaceful community. And once you get out of the community, you run into a maze. The maze will actually change from time to time, and you need to find a way to survive it. So that is what about. With the movie The Maze Runner. And one thing I found out about this movie is this movie actually linked up to a book that I read again recently, which is called Who Moved My Cheese, who actually talks about things changes from time to time and how you survive in a maze and how you find your cheese station. Can I have a show of hand who actually thought of wanted to be a boss one day? That's good. Well, there's nothing wrong or right whether you want to be a boss or you choose to become an employee. But one thing I'd like to share with you is it is not as easy as what you think. Like you see some big bosses, you think they're easy. Actually, their pressure is 10 times more than employees. Don't you agree that? I believe if there's some boss sitting down here, you will actually feel that. Now, my job is not to discourage you to throw away your job, throw away your dream of becoming an entrepreneur, but I would like to share with you the stress of walking in the maze. So what kind of mixed feelings you get while you're in the maze? Let me tell you, I've been out of job for 6 months. I walk the path of the maze. And when you're out of the comfort zone, I tell you what kind of pressure you have. You start to have sleepless night. Think about whether my projects can bring me any income. You think about how long can you survive? Your friend, your in-laws, your people around you. I thought, what are you doing? Do you have a job? And people ask you, do you have a job? What do you want to answer? You cannot say I'm a boss because you're not making any money. That kind of feeling is terrible. And then you start to live your life in the eco mode. You used to go in for fine dining every few days, but then you cut down on all these activities. That is the pleasure that you have when you're walking in a maze. Of course, for people who have born with a silver spoon, that's a different story, right? But if you don't have that silver spoon, you got to find ways how to survive in a maze long enough for you to see your income. Now, in these 6 months, I have tried different things. Well, so far, I reached a point that I think that these projects might work, but unfortunately, it delayed. I'm actually opening a trade route by importing the chilies from Cambodia to Malaysia. Wow. It hasn't reached the shore yet, but once it happened, I can tell you my income will double up from what I used to make. But along the way, I've bumped into a lot of challenges. Imagine, in a third world country like Cambodia, I call up for people to put me in an ocean freight from Sihanouk port to KL. After 3 weeks, nobody gave me a quote. because the country is, does not used to exporting beans, because I need a cold room to put my chilies in. And also the tactics of packaging, how you handle your agriculture products, that's the technique there. So me and my partner actually went fly to Vietnam and tried to spy on the factory in Vietnam just to see how they do this. So there are a lot of things that we have to learn along the way. I don't know whether I will make it. I don't know whether I will fail. Because you never know. That's the uncertainty part that is killing me. But nevertheless, you don't know what will happen. So it's best to stick on your path and try the best. I hope, hopefully, you can see the dawn before you die. Sorry to say that. Now, that's the, just one thing to the base corner.